FamilyTree DNA is the oldest commercial genealogical testing company, but just like the other companies, they have their pros and cons as well. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Today, I'm doing a review of FamilyTree DNA and telling you the things that I like about them and the things that I don't like about them. Now, let me start off by letting you know I haven't actually taken any FamilyTree DNA tests. What I have done is I've transferred results for myself and other family members over to FamilyTree DNA and used their tools on those results. So let's start with the things that I like about FamilyTree DNA. Number one, they have a lot of different testing options. Instead of just one test, one size fits all, they have multiple things divided up between Y-DNA tests, mitochondrial DNA tests, and autosomal DNA tests. In those, you also have different options as far as the number of markers you want to look at in your Y-DNA, whether you want to do the full mitochondrial analysis or just the partial one. And so it is great that there's many different options that you can tailor to the DNA questions that you may have. And that's the number one thing I like about FamilyTree DNA. Now, number two, because FamilyTree DNA is the only company that does separate tests on the mitochondrial DNA and on the Y-DNA, they actually have really good Y-DNA, mitochondrial DNA matching tools where you can match with other people that have the same mitochondrial DNA or Y-DNA and be able to see how far removed you might be. Now, there are other companies that can tell you your haplogroup based off of some of the testing they've done on the Y chromosome or on the mitochondrial DNA. However, that's really the extent of it. FamilyTree DNA goes a step further to actually match up your Y-DNA with other people's Y-DNA and how you might be related to them. So that is the number two reason, is beyond just the autosomal matching, is you also have very good Y-DNA and mitochondrial DNA matching through FamilyTree DNA. And number three, they have a lot of projects on their site that project administrators have started and that people have joined to do research based off of this genetic genealogy. Now, those projects span everything from just a Y DNA, a surname, all the way to your autosome or other things, family groups, location groups, just about anything. If you want to start a project on FamilyTree DNA and be able to get people to join that project, you can do that. Now, some of the benefits of these projects, besides just meeting other people, is several of them are looking for specific ancestors, and they raise funds and will actually pay for the DNA test if you meet certain criteria, because you might be the link that they're looking for that ancestor. So these projects are a great way to learn about genetic genealogy, but also to get with other people who know something about it and help find those people in your family tree that you're looking for. Now, not everything with a company is good, and FamilyTree DNA has some negatives that I see. First off, they do allow uploading of your matches, but to get access to their full suite of tools, you do have to pay a fee for that. Now, I understand this perfectly, because they are focused on genetic genealogy. They don't sell your information for any other reason. And so the only way that they're going to make money and they're going to be able to survive is if they charge for tools. However, they're in competition with other companies that don't charge for uploading and having access to those tools. So that is a negative, but recognize that that's not that big of a charge. I believe right now it's only about $19 if you upload your information and you want to have access to those tools. So they do charge for it, but it is a nominal charge. Number two, FamilyTree DNA allows you to see lots of matches. The one thing that they don't let you see is they don't let you see your matches. Now, this is important if you're trying to do triangulation. You not only need to see your matches, but you also need to see your matches to figure out whether or not you can form a triangulation group. So while they do have some good tools, and while their chromosome browser is excellent as far as seeing detail and where you match and being able to change the amount of centimorgans that you're actually looking at, because you can't see your matches, you don't have the ability to do triangulation just using the FamilyTree DNA tools. You're going to have to upload your information to gedmatch.com or do triangulation manually by contacting these people and finding out who their matches are. Number three, I get the impression that FamilyTree DNA is focused on Y-DNA testing. Now, Y-DNA testing is where genetic testing started, and FamilyTree DNA was one of the first companies to do that. So they have the largest Y-DNA database of any company. However, I rarely see them aggressively advertising their autosomal test, their Family Finder test, and it's not really competing well with other companies. And we can see that is that even though FamilyTree DNA is the oldest company to do commercial genealogical testing, they have, other than MyHeritage, the smallest database. So 23andMe has a much larger database that's about 4 or 5 times the size of FamilyTree DNA's database, and Ancestry has a database that's at least 10 times the size of FamilyTree DNA's database. And Ancestry's only been doing DNA testing for a few years now. So I expect MyHeritage to get a larger database than FamilyTree DNA as well. And again, I think it is because FamilyTree DNA is really focused on Y-DNA testing. Now, I think FamilyTree DNA is missing out on an opportunity here. If they targeted their advertising to build up their autosomal database, I think that people would be able to see some of the genetic matches they have, get excited about that, and be more willing to upgrade to the more expensive Y-DNA testing later, which would also help improve their Y-DNA database. Overall, I really like FamilyTree DNA. If you haven't uploaded your results from 23andMe or Ancestry to FamilyTree DNA, then do that and pay that $20 or so for access to those tools. It gets you into another database, which is a potential to match with more people. If you have any comments about FamilyTree DNA and your experiences with them, put them in the comments section below.
Be sure to check out our website, www.familyhistoryfanatics.com. so that you can find out about upcoming e-conferences that we're going to be a part of. Connect with us on Twitter at FHFanatics or on Facebook, Family History Fanatics, where we can interact with you and respond to your comments.